I want to introduce you to this special pastor here, Kyle Stephen. Let's give him a hand. All right. So he's the leader. He's the mission pastor of First Baptist Church, Hot Spring, Arkansas. 咁咧，呢一位嘅牧師咧係 Kyle Stephen. 咁咧佢係第一浸信會係 Arkansas Hot Spring 第一浸信會嘅宣教嘅牧師嚟嘅。咁啊，今日同我哋程度，我哋歡迎佢好嗎？各位 Kyle.
Well, good morning.
早晨各位。
Pastor Mark mentioned, we have been here this week with our youth group and part of our youth ministry. They've come. We've done some things throughout Chicago. We've been up in Wheeling helping some people planning amongst Russian speakers. So we've been doing surveys, sharing the gospel with people in Wheeling. We've been down here with you guys in Bridgeport. We were over in Wrigleyville this week sharing the gospel, trying to help some church planters over there. So we've just been throughout the city trying to get people interested in churches that are being planted in their
neighborhoods。咁啊，除咗咧喺過去呢幾日咧，佢喺我哋城會教會裏面嚟到服侍咧，佢喺威靈啊，同埋其他嘅地方咧，都去到傳福音啊，特別咧喺北邊，同埋咧喺西郊嘅地方咁樣。This
week here, as on the video, we did a VBC with your kids and youth.
咁咧喺呢個禮拜咧，你見到頭先個影片啦，過去幾日咧，咁咧有一個嘅暑期聖經班同埋青年嘅活動。
And I just want to say thank you from our group for letting us have the week with your children.
咁咧，首先咧，想多谢各位吓，让我哋成教会咧能够去接待佢哋到中间嚟到服侍我哋中间嘅青年人。
Our theme this week was Game On.
咁啊，今年嘅嗰个嘅课程咧叫做 Game On.
And we wanted to try to encourage them to get off the sidelines and get in the game with Jesus this week.
咁啊，其實個主題咧就係話咧，我哋喺個嘅宣教嘅遊戲裏面咧，我哋唔好再做旁觀者咧，我哋走到去場裏面嚟到一齊嚟到去玩呢個遊戲。
And so today, I'm going to bring you a word about a man that decided he was going to step into Jesus's big game.
咁啊，所以咧，今日咧，我想一個人咧，呢一個人咧，就係從一個旁觀者變成咧一個係比賽裡面嘅選手嚟嘅。
All right, let us pray.
我哋祈禱。
Dear Heavenly Father,
天父上帝,
we thank you for today.
我哋為咗今日獻上感謝,
a day which you have given us.
就係呢一日你所定嘅。
Lord, we thank you that we can gather in your name.
上帝，我哋感謝你，我哋今日能夠喺你名裏面聚集。
God, we praise you that we can gather as Chinese Americans, as Arkansans.
咁我哋一齊走埋一齊嘅時候，無論我哋西人係華人。 係任何嘅移民，我哋都能夠喺你嘅主裏面嚟到去聚集。Lord,
that we may speak different languages.
我哋可能講嘅語言唔一樣。And
Lord, we may come from very different places.
我哋可能嘅背景唔一樣。We
all have very different experiences.
我哋過去嘅背景亦唔一樣。But
Lord, you have brought us together under the name of your Son Jesus.
但係喺主嘅名下，你讓我哋能夠一齊聚集。And
so Lord, I pray that your word pierces our heart today.
我哋讓你自己嘅説話嚟進入我哋生命。And
that it moves us to join you in the work you're doing here in Chicago and around the world.
激勵我們,讓我們能夠在芝加哥和世界每一個地方繼續福音工作。
In Jesus' name, amen.
奉耶穌基督名求, amen.
All right, so we are going to be in the book of Ezra today.
今天我們看以斯拉記。
Let me give you a little background of what's happened before we get to our scripture today.
首先,未看聖經之前,給一點背景。
So about 150 years previous to this story, Nebuchadnezzar had taken the Jewish people out of Jerusalem into captivity.
咁喺呢個故事開始之前呢,150年之前呢,尼布甲尼撒巴比倫王呢就將嗰啲猶太人呢俘虜到去異地。
All right, there had been a small group that remained in Jerusalem.
咁只係喺耶路撒冷呢有個好細群嘅猶太人嘅。
But for generations they had been without leadership.
一代一代呢,佢哋都冇一個領袖。
They had been without worship.
咁亦都冇敬拜。
And King Cyrus is going to allow some of the captives to go back to Jerusalem.
咁波斯帝王咧就讓一啲嘅猶太人咧由異地咧翻翻去佢哋嘅鄉下。
Not only is he going to allow them to go back to Jerusalem, he's going to give them money to rebuild the temple.
咁唔單止咧俾佢哋翻翻去佢哋嘅耶路撒冷嘅鄉下地方，亦都俾錢佢哋咧嚟到去建聖殿。
And he's going to send some that are trained in the word and in the law to go back and teach the people.
咁所以咧就容許咧一啲嘅猶太人咧，佢哋係識得律法啊，識得敬拜嘅，翻翻去耶路撒冷嗰度帶領嗰啲子民。
All right, so when we arrive at our text today, the temple has been rebuilt.
咁所以咧，我哋今日睇呢段聖經嘅時候咧，嗰個聖殿咧已經被建造啦。
And a young man named Ezra has returned to Jerusalem.
咁有一個嘅年青人咧，叫做以斯拉，佢咧就翻翻耶路撒冷。
All right, let us look at the word of the Lord.
咁我哋睇下聖經。
We're going to be in Ezra chapter 7, verses 6-10. I'm going to read the entire text in English, and then Mark will follow in Chinese. He was a scribe skilled in the law of Moses, which the Lord, the God of Israel, had given. The king had granted him everything he requested because the hand of the Lord, his God, was on him. Some of the Israelites, priests, Levites, singers, gatekeepers, temple servants accompanied him to Jerusalem in the seventh year of the king Artaxerxes. Ezra came to Jerusalem in the fifth month during the seventh year of the king. He began the journey from Babylon on the first day of the first month and arrived in Jerusalem on the first day of the fifth month, since a gracious hand of his God was on him. Now, Ezra had determined in his heart to study the law of the Lord, obey it, and teach its statutes and ordinances in Israel.
以色列人就是利未人唱歌的守门的利提令有上耶路撒冷的。王帝七年的五月，以色列到达了耶路撒冷。正月初一日，他从巴比伦启程，因为神施恩的手帮助他。五月初一，他就到了耶路撒冷。以色列定义考究遵行耶和华的律法，又将律法典章教导以色列人。
So Ezra has come to Jerusalem.
So Ezra回到耶路撒冷。
And he hasn't come alone.
他不是只是一个人去的。
He's brought with him the traditional people that were needed for temple worship. The Levites, the singers, the gatekeepers. Because Ezra had not come just to live in the city. He had come to bring the worship of God back to the city. There's two important things that the text says that I think we can take with us as we minister in our cities.
今天我们在这段圣经这个故事看到两点，所以我们将它带回我们现在这个城市。
First, we see the phrase, the hand of the Lord was with him, or the hand of his God was upon him.
刚才你听到有一句说话两次重复了，就是上帝的手一路帮助他。
So as Ezra went on this journey, he wasn't doing this on his own. He wasn't doing it in his power. He was doing it because the Lord had urged him to do it. And he was doing it in the power of the Lord. You see, Ezra has a big job. Ezra has to bring worship back to a place that hasn't had worship in six generations. There was no one left in Jerusalem that could remember what temple worship looked like. There was no one left in Jerusalem that understood the law as God had presented it to his people. And Ezra has to go back into this situation and reintroduce the whole idea and concept of worship and the law. And I think whether you live here in Chicago or you live in Hot Springs, as followers of Christ, God has given us the same command. Because God created all people to worship him. And in our heart, we all have a longing for worship. But culture teaches the people around us to worship something else. And they may worship money.
They may worship
power. They may worship how they look. Alright, so everyone is worshiping something. And the people in Jerusalem that Ezra returns to, They weren't void of worship. They were void of the worship of God. And those are the same people that we encounter on a daily basis. They're void of the worship of God. Their heart longs for it. But they don't know how to do it. And God has given us the answers to the question, how do I worship God? And so as followers of Christ, we have to tell people who God is. Who Jesus is. What he's done for them. And bring them into the act of worshiping him. And this is what Ezra is doing in Jerusalem. But Ezra wasn't doing this in his own power. He's doing it in the power of God. And we have that same ability. We have the Holy Spirit as followers of Christ. And in that spirit, in God's Holy Spirit, we are to introduce people to the act of worshiping God.
Alright,
but Ezra also had a second really key ingredient to what he was doing.
Alright,
if you look at verse 10, it says, Now Ezra had determined in his heart to study the law of the Lord, obey it, and teach
it.
See, Ezra didn't go back to Jerusalem with his own ideas in his head. He didn't go back to Jerusalem and say, all right, I'm going to try to figure this out when I get there. Ezra, with the Spirit of the Lord, had a plan. I'm going to dedicate myself to God's word, to his law. I'm going to learn it and I'm going to teach it. I'm
going
to tell people what God's word says. When I was preparing for this sermon this morning, one of the things I learned is that tradition says that Ezra had the entire law memorized. So if you want to kind of put that in your mind, Ezra had essentially memorized the first five books of the Bible. What Moses had written down, what Jewish people call the Torah. Ezra had locked that in his mind. And so when he went back to Jerusalem, he wasn't wondering, what am I going to do with these people? What am I supposed to teach them? He had it. He knew it.
Right?
And the same thing applies for us. When we begin to talk to people about who Jesus is, we need to really know who he is. And we need to know what he says. And if we aren't putting ourselves in his word, if we aren't challenging ourselves, scripture saturate our mind, then we're not going to have the things we need to show people what proper worship is. And so Ezra isn't just trying to figure this out as he goes along. He had a clear plan. He was going to study the law. He was going to obey it. He was going to teach it. And so after we've studied the Word of God and we've learned the Word of God, we need to be in obedience to the Word of God. We need to be obeying it in our daily life. When people look at us and they interact with us, And they need to see that we're different. And they need to see that we speak differently. And that we act differently. And that in the way we speak and we act, we're showing obedience to the word. Yesterday, I was in line to eat at Portillo's. Only come to Chicago once a year, so I try to eat Portillo's often.
每年你芝加哥一定要去Portillo一次。
Italian beef.
所以一定要吃那個意大利的牛。
Hot peppers.
那些熱狗。
And I was standing in line, I began to visit with a man named David behind me.
排隊的時候呢,後面那個人呢,
I could tell there was something different about David. He didn't fit into the crowd.
我見到他有點特別,因為他不像人群一樣。
He was really hot and sweaty.
很熱,流了很多汗。
And as we were standing in line to order, he had a lot of change and he was counting a lot of small bills.
等等的時候,他炒那些散紙,很多散零碎的錢。
And so I just began to strike up a conversation with him.
開始跟他有對話了。
And I asked him, you know, how he was doing, how his day had been.
問他,今天怎樣?你好嗎?
You know, he said he had a really hard day. He'd been outside in the heat all day.
他說外面很熱,今天很辛苦。
He was unemployed, so he was panhandling.
失業,所以就很多。
And he, you know, hoped he had enough money to get a sandwich, and his goal for the day was to find a cool place to sleep that night.
所以今天希望能夠賺到錢,買到食物,然後賺到冷一點的地方能夠在那裡睡。
So I invited David to join me for lunch.
他就去歡迎他,一起吃飯。
Sit at the table together.
一起在同一張桌子坐。
And I began to ask David some questions about God and what he thought about God.
開始問他信仰的問題。
And you know, one of the first things out of his mouth was, oh, I believe in God.
他第一件事他說,我信神。
He said, I believe Jesus is my Savior.
我相信耶穌是我救主。
I was kind of excited and disappointed I wasn't going to get to share the gospel with him.
我有點失望,因為我想跟他傳福音。
But I was excited for him.
但我很為他興奮。
He said, I know God is real because he's taken me through a lot of really difficult situations.
他說,我知道神是誰,因為我以往的困難,神都帶我經過。
And I said, well, you know, you're in a tough situation now.
我說,現在你今天有些困難。
I said, hey, do you mind if I take a minute and I just pray for you right now?
你介不介意我現在立刻為你祈禱?
You know, pray you can get a job.
為到你能夠找到工而祈禱。
Pray you'll have a cool place to sleep tonight.
希望你找到一個涼快一點的地方來睡覺。
And so we prayed.
我們一起祈禱。
And we began to share stories about our families.
一起去分享我們的故事,講我們的家庭。
And it was time for him to go.
他要走了。
But before he left, he said, you know, I've lived in Chicago my whole life.
他未走之前,他說,我整輩子都在芝加哥住的。
And he said, I've never met a stranger that talked about God.
我未見過一個陌生人跟我說神。
But then wanted to listen to me.
並且願意聆聽我說。
And then pray for me.
並且為我祈禱。
So we need to be obedient to what God has asked us to do.
所以呢,我們需要明白上帝對我們說的東西,並且遵行的。
Because we don't know when we're going to be standing in line with a person that's looking for the right thing to worship.
但是因為我們不知道,我們有時候可能就是排隊的時候,後面那個人就需要去明白。
We don't know when the person on the L is hurting and needy.
我不知道火車上那個乘客是不是很受傷,是有需要的。
We've studied God's word.
所以我們去研究神的話。
We're looking to be obedient to God's word.
我們看見上帝的話,來到去遵行它。
We're going to find those situations where we can speak that word into somebody's life. And so like Ezra,
we want to
be looking for those situations where we can be obedient to the word.
見到他就是找到一個時機來到去遵行神的話語。Alright,
so not only was Ezra going to study and obey the word,
不單止以斯拉來到去研究和遵行神的話。He
was going to teach it.
他也去教導人。
See, Ezra was going back into a situation where the people, all of them, none of them knew how to worship God properly.
因為以斯拉回到一個地方,他所有的人都不知道怎樣真正敬拜神。
Many of them are going to think they know what they're doing.
以為知道自己怎樣敬拜神。
But they don't.
但其實不知道。
We're going to, if you flip forward into the end of Nehemiah, you'll see that they find a scroll with the law.
你知道,你要繼續下去看《希米記》,你知道,他們找到神的律法書。
They spend days just huge crowd reading the law.
咁啊，成個會眾咧開始第一次去到睇神嘅話語。
Because they didn't know all of it.
因為佢哋之前唔知道嘛。
See, we know the truth of Christ.
我哋就知道咧，基督嘅道。
As followers.
我哋作為門徒。
And it's not merely telling someone about Jesus and then hoping they figure it out on their own.
唔係淨係話俾佢聽耶穌係邊個，等佢哋自己搞掂啦咁。
It's walking that with them. It's teaching them what Jesus has taught us.
而係同佢哋同行，你都話俾佢哋聽，解釋俾佢聽，基督話俾我哋聽嘅命令。
And so Ezra has given us a great model for how we do this.
咁啊，所以咧，以斯拉俾我哋一個好嘅榜樣咧，我點樣去行呢樣嘢出嚟？
Right. First, we need to understand that we don't do that in our own power.
咁啊，我第一樣要知道，我哋咧唔係靠住我哋能力嚟做嘅。
We do it in the power of the Spirit.
我哋係藉住神嘅靈嚟到做。
The hand of the Lord is on us.
因為神施恩嘅手去幫助我哋。
All right. And then we have to study and learn who Jesus is on our own.
咁我哋研究，我哋去考究嚇，到底點樣去應用喺我哋生命。
And then we have to be obedient to it.
而且我哋願意嚟到去進行。
And then we have to teach others.
並且去教導其他嘅人。
All right, and so we're in a great position.
我哋咧係一個好好嘅一個時機。
Because we have the Spirit of God in our heart as followers of Christ.
因為我哋作為基督嘅門徒咧，我哋已經有聖靈喺我哋心裏面。
And so if we're sensitive to that,
如果咧我哋係敏感嘅話咧，
we're going to find people in our communities.
我哋咧就會喺社區裏面揾到我哋需要嘅人。
Whether here in Chicago,
無論喺芝加哥，
or Hot Springs,
或者Hot Springs，
that we can teach them who God is and how to properly worship Him.
我哋就能夠教導呢啲人嚟到點樣去真正敬拜神。
So, what I want you to do now,
我而家想你咧做嘅咧，
is if you'll just kind of bow your heads.
咁啊，你一齊嚟到低頭，我哋去祈禱。
We're going to have a time to respond to what God is showing us.
我哋咧有一個時間咧，讓神嘅道咧嚟進入我哋。
Maybe you're not a follower of Christ. Maybe you come here on Sunday. Maybe somebody invited you today. And you need to be obedient to acknowledging who Jesus is. You need to acknowledge and respond that like all of us, you are a sinner. That Christ is the only way to salvation. He died on the cross for you. He lives today. And He is the only way to relationship with God. So if that's you today, we're going to ask you to come and let one of the pastors, one of the leaders of the church know. Let them talk to you. But you know, probably for many of us in the room, we know Jesus. We know His commands. We know Him as Savior. But maybe we don't study His Word. Maybe we don't teach His commands. Maybe we have disobedience in our life. And so if that's you, I'm going to challenge you to come put that here at the altar this morning. If you're uncomfortable with that, I'm going to challenge you to quietly, in your own mind, acknowledge that you want to be one that knows the Word, obeys the Word, and teaches the Word. I want you to begin to think of the faces of the people in your neighborhood. Maybe the students that sit next to you in class and school. Maybe the person at the corner store or the bodega that you shop in daily. And how can you be obedient to share who Christ is with them? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have given us your word. God, we praise you that you have given us salvation through your Son. Lord, we praise you that we can't come to you on our own, Lord. But you came to us through the person of your Son Jesus. And so God, we confess our sin to you today. Lord, we make a commitment to you to be in your word. Like Ezra, Lord, we want to be determined to study your word. God, like Ezra, we want to be obedient to it. And like Ezra, Lord, we want to step into somebody's life and we want to teach them your word. Lord, I want to specifically pray for Urban Voice Church. Lord, you've given Mark and his team a great vision to reach into this community. Lord, you've given them great resources to do that with. And so God, we just ask today that you continue to bless them. Lord, you continue to let them know that they're not doing this in their own power. Every life they intersect with, every person they come into contact with, Lord, that is because your spirit is amongst them. And Lord, as they look for new ways to interact with their community, Lord, let them do that in your spirit. Lord, again, we thank you for allowing us to be here today. To have a place to love and to worship you. God, and we pray whether we're here in Chicago or whether we're in Hot Springs, that we take the gifts that you've given us, the knowledge of your word, and we shine like a bright light in our community. In Jesus' name, amen.
奉耶稣基督的名求，阿门。